Hello everybody, today we will see the introduction to ABCD parameters of transmission line. We can express transmission line in form of two port network as it is shown in the figure. This is the input side, this is the output side. We know that in any four terminal electric network which is linear, bilateral and passive, input voltage and input current can be expressed in terms of output voltage and output current. This phenomena or this principle we can use to express our sending end voltage and sending end current in terms of receiving end voltage and receiving end current. Here note that Vs is the per phase sending end voltage, Vr is the per phase receiving end voltage, Is is the per phase sending end current, Ir is the per phase receiving end current. ABCD are the parameters of transmission line which depends on the type of transmission line and the method by which ABCD parameters are calculated. Now we can express Vs and Is in terms of Vr and Ir as follows. We can write Vs equal to AVr plus BIr, Is equal to CVR plus DIR. Okay, so let us call this as equation number 1, equation number 2. So VS, IS are the sending end voltages and current respectively, VR, IR are the receiving end voltage and current respectively, ABCD are the line parameters. Okay, so in matrix form we can express above equation as follows. So this is the matrix form of the above equation. Okay, so here main advantage of this method is that once we determine ABCD parameters of any line, we can determine Vs and Is by using this equation. And once we determine Vs and Is, we can determine other electrical parameters like sending end power factor, voltage regulation, transmission efficiency, etc. So few important points. ABCD are usually the complex number. Now if you consider the units of ABCD, so if I write the units, then A and D are usually unitless. There is no unit, they are the constant number. B has a unit of ohms and C has a unit of Siemens. What it means, B is some kind of impedance and C is some kind of admittance which has a unit of Siemens. So one more important point, if your line is symmetric, so for symmetrical network, for symmetrical network, A is equal to D, and for reciprocal network, product of AD minus BC is equal to 1. Okay, so this is applicable, A equal to D if your line is or the network is symmetric, and this equation is valid, AD minus BC equal to 1. If your network is a reciprocal. Now remember, all these quantities Vs, Is, A, B, C, D, Vr, Ir all are complex numbers. So usually bar is placed over all these quantities, but just for simplicity I am not indicating the bar. Now how to determine the voltage regulation? Now we know that voltage regulation of transmission line, so percentage voltage regulation of line Vr, it is given by Vr no load minus Vr full load divided by Vr full load into 100 percentage. Now how to obtain Vr no load? Now see the equation number 1. When we say there is a no load condition, what it means is that no current will flow through the load, so Ir will be 0. So if I put IR equal to 0, whatever VS is there or whatever VR is there, so that will be VR no load. So if you put IR equal to 0 in equation number 1, so putting IR equal to 0 in equation number 1. Putting IR equal to 0 in equation 1. So what we will get? Vs equal to A into VR no load. Okay? Because if IR is 0, this term will be 0. So Vs will be equal to A into VR no load. So from this, what will be magnitude of VR no load? It will be magnitude Vs upon A. Okay, now put this value in original equation of voltage regulation. So we can write voltage regulation as Vs divided by A minus VR full load divided by VR full load into 100. So this will give us percentage voltage regulation. Okay, so once we determine ABCD parameter, practically receiving end voltage at a given full load, it is given. So Vs we have determined by using this particular equation. Okay, so we can obtain percentage voltage regulation. Transmission efficiency, already you know how to determine transmission efficiency. It is ratio of receiving end power by sending end power, and already we have determined VSIS. From that we can determine PS, sending end power, and receiving end power is usually specified in the problem. Okay, so I hope you have understood what are the ABCD parameters and how they can be used for the analysis of transmission layer. Thank you.